Okay, this is your syllabus. Out of the syllabus, we have discussed that cost classification and the cost behavior, right? Thereafter, we have discussed that process costing, right? Then I have moved into the standard costing of the variances, variance part. Now I am going to select the topic chapter 12, short term decision making. Actually, the short term decision making totally consists marginal costing techniques. From the CVP analysis, cost volume profit analysis, and how it can be used for decision making, right? Long term decision making, the chapter 12, 13 consists project appraisals. The calculation of IRR, NPV, payback, discounted payback, both the additional and contemporary project appraisal technique. That is chapter 13. Chapter 12, today I am going to start MCQ questions for marginal costing and short term decision making. But one thing I need to tell you, we don't have enough time to discuss all the chapters. The chapter 14 is very important chapter for you because it consists the probability and probability distributions. I think you already referred the chapters, right? The probability and probability distribution is there, therefore you have to practice for that. Today I will take short that MCQ questions for short term decision making, right? The question number 1 for short term decision making: which of the following statement is or are correct? That is, one or more may be correct, right? You have been given 3 statements. This is about CVP analysis and short term decision making, right? The incremental cost of buying a larger quantity of material might be a negative cost, which is a cost reduction. If a company reduces its selling price by 20%, so that sales volume increased by 25%, total profit remain unchanged. A direct cost need to be a variable cost, but might be a fixed cost, right? These are the 3 statements they have given, but to answer this type of question, you require the basic knowledge of marginal costing. I will recap the knowledge. Marginal costing basically divide the cost into 2 categories as variable cost and fixed cost, right? When it comes to the financial accounting, it is classifying their expenses as cost of sale, administration cost, sale and distribution, likewise according to the function. Here we are classifying as direct cost and variable cost and fixed cost. Therefore, using variable cost and fixed cost, we are preparing marginal cost in P&L, sales minus variable cost, then you have the contribution, then you will deduct fixed cost from the contribution to have the net profit. That's the basic of the marginal costing, and we have few assumptions there in marginal costing. We assume the fixed cost remain unchanged, will not change with the number of units within the capacity level. It's remain unchanged. Since it is remain unchanged, when the production quantity increasing, variable cost per unit will decrease. That's a very important point. If you have only 1 unit, fixed cost is the cost per unit. But when you have 2 units, fixed cost will divide by 2 units to have the cost per unit. Therefore, when the production quantity increasing, fixed cost per unit will decrease. But total fixed cost remain unchanged within the capacity level. When it comes to the variable cost per unit will remain unchanged. Per unit will remain unchanged. With the number of units, total variable cost will increase. Selling price per unit also remain unchanged. But with the number of units increasing, the total revenue will increase. These are the basic assumptions, right? And most important assumption is expenses can be divided into 2 categories, that is variable cost and fixed cost. Now you have been given 3 sentences here. You have to evaluate one by one. The incremental cost of buying a larger quantity of material. Incremental cost is the additional cost. Buying a larger additional cost you must incur to buy larger quantity of material might be a negative cost, which is a cost reduction. Yes or not? Yes? cost will reduce, but it will not be a negative value, right? Then if a company reduces its selling price by 20%, so that sales volume increase by 25%, total profit will remain unchanged. A direct cost need to be a variable cost, but might be a fixed cost. What is the answer? A, one only, correct. B, 1 and 2, C, 2 and 3, D, 1 and 3. Easily, I think you can say what is correct, what is wrong, but is it difficult? But you need to understand why the reason to tell that, why we are telling that, right? Let's move into the answer. Answer is D. Let's see why. Statement 1 can be correct when there is a bulk discount on larger quantities. For example, see, suppose there is a bulk purchase discount of 10% on item costing 10 each. For order above 100,000 units, if you're buying 100,000 units, your cost will be 1 million. Cost of say 110,000, you will have 10% discount, then price will be 9 for 110,000 units. Dollar not 10, it will be $9, 10% discount. Then your total cost will be 410,990,000 units. Incremental cost means the additional cost you charge, cost you pay, the additional cost actually reduced by 10,000. Is that clear? Therefore, statement 1 can be considered as a correct sentence when you consider bulk purchases. Statement 2 is correct for sales revenue but no profit. Clear? When the sales price decrease, you know, according to the demand theory, when the price decrease, demand will increase and sales will increase. Clear? Sales price decrease by 20%, quantity increase by 25%. Therefore, revenue will increase. Clear? But profit, you cannot say always profit will increase or remain unchanged. Right? Statement 3 is correct. A direct cost is a cost that can be identified separately in a product cost, service cost or department cost. Direct cost can often be fixed cost. For example, the salary of the manager of a department A is a fixed direct cost of the department. Can you understand what they mention? Direct cost is a cost that can be identified separate in a product cost, service cost or department cost. They just mention only direct cost. They not mention direct production cost. They just mention direct cost. Direct cost is a cost that can be identified with a unit you produce, or a dip with a department, or with a section. Is that clear? Because they did not specify it is direct production cost. Direct department direct cost, section direct cost. Within that, you can have fixed costs such as salary of the supervisors. Is that clear? Got it? 1 and 3 because the 2 incorrect. Profit, we cannot say profit will remain unchanged. Revenue will be the answer, but not the profit. Direct cost, they did not specify it is production cost. Direct cost, direct for department, direct for section, direct for CA Sri Lanka, direct for country, whatever unit you identify. Within that you can have some fixed cost, right? Production department cost is a direct cost of that department. Is that clear? Then production supervisor salary is a fixed cost within the department, right? Question 2. A company makes a single product and incurs fixed cost, 30,000 per unit, per month. Variable cost per unit, 5, and each unit sells for 15. Look the story. You will produce or buy unit at $5 and sell it at $15. Then you have a net gain of $10. Am I correct? That is the contribution according to the marginal costing. That contribution should be sufficient enough to pay the fixed cost. If you have contribution more than the fixed cost, that is your profit. Is that clear? That's why fixed cost will divide by contribution to have the break-even point units. Clear? If I ask a question to calculate break-even point units, why we divide fixed cost by contribution? If examiner asks a question, what is the reason for that? I'm not talking about this question. If somebody asks you to calculate break-even point units, your formula will be fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Why you are getting fixed cost as the numerator in the formula? The rationale behind that, to have fixed cost there? Sorry? Oh, you are getting fixed cost and it will divide by the contribution per unit. Why you are getting fixed cost for that purpose? We are talking about the break-even point. Before moving to this, I think better to understand that. Right? If somebody asks, okay, why we are getting fixed cost to calculate break-even point units, you should have answer. It's not a formula, right? Formula has been prepared by people. How people that's produced. Okay, let's take the same answer. Sales price, said 15. Variable cost per unit, said 5, right? 5. Fixed cost, total fixed cost said 30,000. Okay, let's do a calculation now. Okay, let's assume we are producing 0 units , 3000 units, and according to the question 7000 units. Clear? Now you can calculate the PNL. PNL says revenue minus total variable cost. Clear? Minus total variable cost, then you have contribution, then you deduct total fixed cost to have the net profit. Here revenue will be 0. Clear? No units. Variable cost also 0, no units. Therefore, contribution will be 0, since no units, contribution will be 0, but fixed cost 30,000, right? Therefore, your net profit will be minus 30,000. Clear? This is the story when you produce in 0 units, right? Now let's see you are producing 0 units, then let's see for 30,000 units, sorry, 3000 units and 7000 units. If it is 3000, you know 3000 into 15, clear? The revenue will be, sorry, variable cost will be 3000 into 5, then contribution will be 30,000, fixed cost 30,000, net profit 0. This called break even point situation. Clear? When it's come to 7,000 unit situation, now we are talking three scenarios, right? 7,000 situation. Revenue will be 7,000 into 15. Variable cost 7,000 into 5. Therefore, 70,000, right? 70,000 contribution. Fixed cost 30,000. Therefore, profit 40,000. In the break even, this is the break even line, no profit, no loss. To calculate the number of units, what we are doing? Fixed cost divided by contribution. Actually, you have to divide contribution by contribution per unit. You have to divide total contribution by, okay, for an example, when you to have 70,000 contribution, how many units you have to sell? 70,000 divided by 10. Total contribution 70,000 here. Clear? To see the number of units, 70,000 total contribution will divide by 10. Then you can say answer is 7,000. Clear? But to have zero profit, you are not getting this 30,000, you are getting this 30,000. Why? They are the same. That's the reason answer for my question. At the break-even point, total contribution and fixed cost will be same. Therefore, even you use fixed cost or contribution, your answer will be same. I think you got the point. Now, when it's come to a expected profit situation, remember, fixed cost divided by net, sorry, fixed cost plus net profit. Fixed cost plus net profit finally ended with the contribution, 70,000. Your formula was, am I correct? With the, you need to earn 40,000 expected profit. 40,000 expected profit. What is the quantity? Fixed cost plus expected profit divided by contribution per unit. Am I correct? Why we are getting fixed cost plus expected profit? Because it is ended with 70,000. Finally, contribution will divide by contribution. When it's a break even, total contribution equal fixed cost. When it's a expected profit, fixed cost plus profit equal contribution. Clear? That's the rationale. Right? Okay. Second question. Monthly sales demand 7,000 units. The break-even point in terms of monthly sales will be 3,000 units. Clear? Right. Question 3. A company manufactures a single product for which cost and selling price data are as follows. Selling price 12, variable cost 8, contribution 4. Fixed cost per month 96,000. When 96,000 divided by 4, it is 24,000 units. Am I correct? They have a break-even point according to the information given, 24,000 units. While you reading, you have to imagine everything because this is a MCQ question. Selling price 12, variable cost 8, contribution 4. Is that clear? Therefore, to recover at least the fixed cost, 96,000 need to be recovered by using $4 by $4 from each unit. Am I correct? That is the story. Clear? I will ask you to do something. Select a small entrepreneur or sole proprietor in your home, sorry, in your village. Small sole proprietorships running business ones, uneducated people, even not past grade 5 sometimes in villages, clear? Small businessmen, those who are running small shops in the village, clear? But if you ask them to sell your item in their shop, they will analyze everything within few minutes. Is that clear? Using this technique. I will tell you, think as a businessman. I will give you my room to do the business. You have to pay 96,000 rent for me. For all electricity, water, everything, you have to pay 96,000 for me. And I will supply my item at $8 for you. You can sell it at 12. Clear? Then you can earn only $4 from one unit. However, you have to pay 96,000 to me. How many units you have to at least sell? 24,000 units. That's called break-even. Clear? Budgeted monthly sales, 30,000. That means you can earn a profit only from balance 6,000 units. Am I correct? Why? Up to 24,000 units, you don't have a saving. You have to pay for me. This is marginal costing, not theories. Then any unit more than 24,000 will make a saving for you. That's why it's called margin of safety. Safety. Company will continue if you have profit. The profit will generate from the unit after the break-even point. Therefore, 24,001 is the first unit make $4 for you. Therefore, any unit more than 24,000 is the margin of safety. The margin of safety expressed as a percentage of monthly sales. Margin of safety is only 6,000. Is that clear? Additional, how much you have? 6,000 unit. As a percentage of 30,000. Clear? That is 1/5. Am I correct? 1/5. 20%. Clear? Don't take these wordings as technical words. That's the problem we have. Right? Now, 4, 5 and 6, 3 questions based on this information. Right? Okay, just read and analyze the given information. See how I am reading. Selling price 6, variable production cost, variable selling cost. You have 2 variable cost, totally 1.6 variable cost. Selling price 6, 6 minus 1.6 will be 4.4. Therefore, contribution is $4.4. You have to summarize everything in your mind. You have 2 fixed cost, fixed production cost, fixed selling cost. Per unit basis they have given. Again, it is not the total per unit basis. Per unit, you have 4.8 fixed cost. But you don't know what is the total fixed cost. You know per unit it will be 4.8. You have budgeted to produce 10,000 units. Fixed cost always setting for the budgeted quantity or actual quantity. Fixed cost generally setting for budgeted quantity. Why? Fixed cost will remain unchanged within their capacity. Can you remember my first day lesson? Fixed cost will remain unchanged within their capacity. Therefore, fixed cost will depend on the capacity, not the actual production. Sometimes actual production may more than the budgeted value. Actual production may less than the budgeted value, but fixed cost align with the budgeted quantity or capacity. You are telling you 4.8 per unit fixed cost. Your capacity is 10,000 units. Therefore, 4.8 into 10,000 unit will be the total fixed cost. That is $48,000 is the total fixed cost of the business. Agreed? Got it? Don't multiply fixed cost per unit always by the actual production. It will be multiplied by the budgeted production or the capacity of the business. Is that clear? Therefore, total fixed cost is 48,000. Question also, break even point, 48,000 should be divided by 4.6 or 4.4. How much? You will have a decimal answer. 8,333. 10,909. Right? That is answer D. Clear? Question 5. How many units must be sold to achieve a profit of 11,000? Okay, you know. You don't have a profit when you are earning 48,000 contribution. Now you need profit 11,000. Therefore, 48,000 plus 11,000 is the expected contribution to have 11,000 profit. That is 59,000 contribution should be earned. Is that clear? Because keep your mind, profit is additional contribution after deducting fixed cost. Can you define it as? Don't say profit is profit in marginal costing. See how I am going to define. Profit is the additional contribution after deducting fixed cost from the total contribution. Therefore, to have the total contribution in a given profit, add fixed cost. Therefore, it is 59,000 is the total contribution. Agreed? Dhyabhi purudhila thi nimi nimi isthara pirivayakutu kirima. Fixed cost plus expected profit. Even ikan itandema fixed. Profit is the additional contribution, right? Then additional contribution plus fixed cost is the total contribution. Divide by 4.4. Then what is the expected quantity? 13,000. Sorry? 13,409. Answer D. Right. It is now expected that variable production cost per unit. I'm reading question number 6. It is now expected that variable production cost per unit and selling price per unit will each increase by 10%. Is that clear? Both selling price and variable cost will increase by 10%. Expected that, look here, you have variable cost for both production and sales, right? But here, variable production cost per unit and selling price increase by 10%. Fixed production cost will raise by 25%. What will be the new break-even point? Okay, let's take this information into the given points. Selling price increase by 10%, right? Then 6.6, note down. 6.6. Okay? Here this information will change. Let's take new information. Selling price will be 6.6. Then variable production cost also increased by 10%. That is, variable cost, that is production. Clear? Currently how much? 1.2. Increased by 10%. Then how much? 1.2 into 1.1. 1 plus 10%, 1.32, 1.32, other variable cost remain as 4, clear, you have to consider it as 4. That is variable cost selling, right? That is 0.4. Now see the contribution. How much the contribution? Six point six minus 1.72. How much with it? 4.88, right? 4.4 dollars and 88 cents, right? This is the contribution. Okay. Then they have mentioned another information about fixed cost, right? Fixed cost will increase by fixed production cost. Again, fixed production cost increase by 25%. Let's see the fixed production cost. Fixed cost production increase by 25%. 4 into 10, 40,000, right? 4 is 1, 4, 1 into 10,000 units, that is 40,000. Then total, sorry. Fixed production cost, currently 4 into 10,000 units, clear? Then it's become 40,000. Okay? Increase by 25% means 1.25, you have to multiply. Then it's become 50,000. 50,000. Again, you have fixed cost, sales also, right? What was that? 0.8, right? 0.8. into 10,000, that is 8,000. Therefore, total fixed cost 58,000. Now you require to calculate new break-even point, fixed cost divided by contribution per unit, that is new BEP in quantity is 58,000 divided by 4.88. Answer. Do you have the answer? This is the answer. What the mistake you can made here? Only fixed production cost increase by 25%. Is that clear? Be careful. Then only variable production cost increase by 10% and selling price increase by 10%. That is variable selling cost or variable, sorry, fixed selling cost remain unchanged. You have to apply only increased value into the existing value. Is it clear? Six, then seven. Try to answer 7 and 8. I told you what you need to do. You have to calculate, what you have to calculate? Margin of safety. Then what you need to do? We can write down what we already aware about that. Margin of safety, right, equal additional sales more than the break even. Is that clear? Therefore, actual quantity sold minus BEP quantity. Clear? Therefore, only two figures you have to find out. What are two figures you have to find out? Actual sales quantity and BEP quantity to answer this question. Ready? A company makes a single product which is sales 10 per unit, fixed cost 48,000 per unit, sorry, per month, and the product has a contribution to sales ratio. On sales, 40% contribution, right? That is, contribution is 4. Contribution to sales ratio means contribution divided by sales. Is that clear? That is 40%. 40% means $4. Therefore, contribution 4, variable cost 6, since selling price is 10. Agreed? Okay, contribution 4, fixed cost 48. Therefore, break-even units 12,000. Is that clear? Break-even point 12,000. You already sold $140,000 at $10 per unit. That is 14,000 units you already sold. Therefore, additional sales you made only 2,000 units. Is that clear? Therefore, say margin of safety will be 2,000 units. Answer A. Agree? The corner, put up. Okay. Last. You understood? Contribution to sales ratio means contribution divided by sales. As a percentage, 40%. 40% means contribution will be 40% on sales. That is $4. Since contribution 4, fixed cost 48, BEP will be 12,000 units. Clear? Then you already sold $140,000 at $10 per unit. That is 14,000 units. You sold BEP 12,000. Therefore, you have additional sales of 2,000 units. Clear? Okay. Somebody will ask you to calculate net profit. What is the answer? Any additional unit more than BEP is for your profit. One unit you will have $4 profit. Therefore, here you have 2,000 into 4 net profit. 2,000 into 4. Additional sales you made, margin of safety. How much? 2,000. How much you can save from one unit? $4. Therefore, 2,000 into 4 is 8,000. Net profit will be 8,000. Is that clear? No need to prepare the P&L account and calculate it. We just analyzing all the information. Is that clear? Question 8. A single product. Company has a contribution to sales ratio 40%. Fixed cost amount to 90,000 per annum. Right? The number of units required to break even. In the break-even, fixed cost and contribution is equal or not? Equal or not? Equal. Therefore, 90,000 is equal to the contribution when we have a break even. 90,000 as a total say contribution is equal to 40% of the sales. Therefore, if you divide 90,000 by 40%, you can have total sales. Is that clear? Total sales will be 225,000. Clear? Right. 225,000 is the total sale revenue in dollars, not the quantity. To calculate the quantity, at least you need the sales price per unit. Or you should have another mechanism to find out sales price per unit or contribution per unit. See whether you have any method to find out contribution per unit or sales price per unit. What would be the answer? D. Lazy ke nahi, impossible to calculate without further information. The number of units required to break even. What is the answer? A. B, C, D. D. Don't you have a method? Do you have a method to find out selling price per unit or variable cost per unit? No. Just see. They ask him break-even point. To calculate break-even point, we required fixed cost and the contribution per unit. We have fixed cost, but we don't have contribution per unit or sales price per unit or variable cost per unit. Therefore, we cannot say. Now, you can imagine what I have told you last, you can think what I have told you last day, evening. If examiner asks a question, what we need to do? Write down the available formula or the method can be used to solve the question. Is that clear? Is D right? Okay, let's take 9. Question 9 and 10. See what I am going to do. They are asking company's margin of safety. That is break-even sales and actual sales required. Difference is margin safety. Okay, try to find out. Here you can calculate actual sales 224,000 divided by sales price 16. Then you can have actual sales quantity, right? 3264. How much actual quantity? 14,000. 14,000 units. Actual sales. Now we have to calculate break-even sales. How we can calculate break-even sales? Contributions to sales ratio of 40% on sales. Therefore, we can directly calculate contribution as 1.6 into 4, for 6.4, clear? That is contribution per unit. Sales price 16 into 40%. That is 6.4, right? Then BEP in quantity. Fixed cost 76,800 divided by 6.4 equal how many units? 13,000. 12,000. Therefore, BEP is any additional quantity you produce more than that. So, say margin of safety is the additional quantity more than the BEP. That is answer A, 2,000 units. Sorry? Sorry? Okay. Am I correct? The calculation is right. Okay. Now let's see question 10. What they are asking? What are the company's annual fixed? Now I need only this. I need to find out fixed cost. That's my task. Now whatever the calculation I will do for this to calculate fixed cost, right? Okay, let's see what are the information. Company's break-even point is 6,000. In the break-even point, total contribution equal total fixed cost. Therefore, calculate total contribution. Selling price 90, variable 40. Therefore, contribution per unit is 90 minus 40 equal $50. Is that clear? Therefore, total contribution will be 15 to 6,000 at the break even. That is 300,000 or 3 million. 300,000. 300,000 is the total contribution at BEP. Both fixed cost and BEP contribution will same at the BEP point. Then, ඇයි ෆෝමියුලා පාඩම් කරන්න එපා පුතේ කවදාවත්. කවුරු මොන ෆෝමියුල එක දුන්නත් ඊවන් මී ගිවන් යූ ෆෝමියුලා ආස්ක් වයි වයි වී ආර් යූසින් දිස් ෆිගර්ස් ක්ලියර්. Therefore, answer C. Fixed cost will be C. Right? Better write down these figures because we have to move into the questions. Okay, note down these figures. Don't just note down, right? While you note down, calculate. Selling price 20, direct material, direct labor, variable production overhead, variable selling overhead, fixed overhead, 4, 3, 7, and 10. Variable cost 10, fixed cost, variable cost 10. Agreed? Variable cost 10, selling price 20, contribution to 10, contribution will be 10, fixed cost per unit 5. We have to find out the budgeted quantity to calculate the total fixed cost. Is that clear? Because always fixed cost per unit will be multiplied by budgeted quantity to have the total fixed cost. Contribution will be 10 because we have 4 categories of variable. As a total it is 10. 20 minus 10 is 10. Contribution 10. Clear? Ready? The profit volume ratio. How to calculate profit volume ratio? Profit is 5, right? According to the information given, profit is 5, right? Profit divided by sales, 25%. Is that clear? Contribution divided by sale, 50%. Now they are asking profit volume ratio. Write down the formula profit volume ratio equal. Write down formula profit volume ratio equal contribution divided by selling price PV ratio. This is same as what? Contribution to sales ratio. Therefore, note down PV ratio and CS ratio is the same. Contribution to sales ratio, CS ratio, profit volume ratio, same. Is that clear? Don't misunderstand. Even if it is profit volume ratio, contribution to sales ratio, it is same, contribution divided by sales. Contribution I think 10, right? Contribution 10, sales price 20, therefore ratio will be 50%, right? That is 50% B, right? Two, three, four, three questions. Just write down these figures. Selling price 10, variable 6, fixed cost per unit 2, the contribution 4, total fixed cost 10,000, right? Total fixed cost 10,000. Why? Fixed cost per unit 2, budgeted quantity 5,000, fixed cost 10,000, contribution per unit 4. Ne? Then break even point would be 2500, right? 2500. The question, how many units must be sold if company wishes to earn 6000 profit? That means you need 16,000 contribution. Agreed? If you want 6000 profit, your contribution would be that plus fixed cost. That is 16,000, right? Then 16,000 divided by 4, it is 4,000 units. Answer C. Got it? Abad uttare. I am adhina puta tawe na uttare ne. Huh? Theruni peli. Therunne ne? Therunne? Do you know why you are not getting understand? Api pute oyala okkoma poduye. ගණන් හදද්දි ફોકસ කරන්න එපා හදන ගන්නට. ඔයාලා ගෙදර ගිහිල්ලා වීඩියෝ එක අරගෙන මේ වීඩියෝ එක අරගෙන බලන් දෙපා. මොකද කරන්න ඕන? අහන් ඉන්න. අහන් ඉන්නකෝ වීඩියෝ එක. ඒ ඇහෙන ටික වටිනවා දකින්න දෙයට වඩා. මතකද පටන් ගනිද්දි මං කිව්වා මං ඉස්සලා සිංහලෙම කියලා ඉන්නම්කෝ. පටන් ගනිද්දි කිව්වා when we I think increasing ලාභ නොලබන අවස්ථාවේදී ෆික්ස් කොස්ට් එකයි කන්ට්‍රිබියුෂන් එකයි සමානයි. ලාභ නව ඇයි? කන්ට්‍රිබියුෂන් අඩු කිරීම ෆික්ස් කොස්ට් එක තමයි ලාභය කියන එක 0. ලාභය ලබන අවස්ථාවේදී ෆික්ස් කොස්ට් එකට වඩා කන්ට්‍රිබියුෂන් එක වැඩි. වැඩි ටික තමයි net profit එක වෙන්නේ. නේ? එහෙනම් ඒ වෙලාවේ quantity එක හදන්න අපි මොකද කරන්න ඕනේ? ෆික්ස් කොස්ට් ප්ලස් profit. ඒක ෆෝමියුලාක් විතර පාඩම් කරන්න එපා. फिक्स कॉस्ट फिक्स के कैपैसीटी के अतुले फिक्स कॉस्ट का दंड होना फिक्स कॉस्ट पर यूनिट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बजटेड क्वांटिटी और कैपैसीटी सिद्धांत उलवे मम गाना हदन गम की टीके वाला गाना द्राई करना मिसा आंगी कोई पॉइंट्स टीकाउट गया लेते मम्मी मम्मी उगा හරි මම නිකන් වලට මේ ටික කියන්නකො මොකද මේ ගමන වල යන්න මේ ආරම්භ කරලා ණයක් කාලා ඒ ණය කාපු ගමන් පොළඟකුත් කාලා නේ ඉන්නේ හරි අපි ඉස්සර විහිළුවට කිව්වේ KE2 සබ්ජෙක්ට් එක CA ළමයිට ණය විසයි පොළොන් විසයි එකට දෙනවා කියලා එනි කොස්ටිම් මැත්ස් එකට දාලා දෙනකොට ඉතින් ණය පොළඟ එකපාර කාලා නේ වල ඉන්නේ ඔය ණය පොළඟ එකපාර කෑවේ නැත්තම් මේ වෙනකොට බිස්නස් ලෙවල් උත් ඉවරයිනේ පරණ සිලබස් එකේ නේ තමාට ඉවර වෙන්න පුළුවන් නේ මේ නිසා ඉර වෙන්න ඇතිනේ ඇයියේ හිර වුණේ කියලා කවදාවත් හිතුවේ නැද්ද පුතේ හිතුවේ නැද්ද අයියෝ you were stuck there කියලා හිතුවේ නැද්ද අන්න ඒක තේරුම් ගත්ත නම් හරි I will tell you a small story I think it will be helpful you for you right මම A level කර පළවෙනි පාර B3යි. කොමර්ස් කරේම B3යි. right? එතකොට කැම්පස් යන මදි. මම මාස 7ක් එක දිගට පාඩම් කරා. මහන්සියලා වැඩ කරා B3යි. හරි. දෙවනි පාර විභාගෙ මන් දැම්මේ නෑ. ඔය ඇම්බලිපිටිය ජාතික පාසලේ ඉන්න ප්‍රියන්ත දිසානායක කියලා සර් කෙනෙක්. එයා තමයි එකවුන්ස් ඉගන්නේ. ඒ සර් මට විභාගෙ දාලා ඉස්කෝලේ ඉඳානේ දෙවනි පාර. මං ඉන්න තැනට හොයාගෙන ඇවිල්ලා කිව්වා උඹට ඉස්කෝලේ විභාගෙ දාලා තියෙන්නේ. එලා ලියහන්. අපේ පාර අගෝස්තු විභාගෙ තිබිලා සෙකන්සයි අපිට ආවේ අප්‍රේල්. ඒක පාරම අප්‍රේල් වලට එක්සෑම් එකක් ගෙනාවා 2002. හරි. දැන් එතකොට විභාගෙ රිසල්ට් ආවේ දෙසැම්බර්. සෙකන්සයි එක්සෑම් දැන් මේ ජනවාරි. ජනවාරි මාසේ අන්තිම වගේ සර් මට ඇවිල්ලා කිව්වා විභාගෙ දැම්මා ලියහන්. දැන් තව මාස දෙකයි විභාගෙත්. මම කල්පනා කරා සර් කිව්වා සර්ලා ගෙදර එන්න කියලා. මම සර්ලා ගෙදර කියලා වාඩිලා කල්පනා කරා. දැන් කොහොමද මම මාස දෙකකින් ලියන්නද මේ මාස හතක් වැඩ කරලා බී තුනක් නම් දැන් මාස දෙකක් වැඩ කරලා කොහොමද මම කැම්පස් යන්නේ කියලා. කල්පනා කර කර ඉදි මට තේරුණා මගේ මොකක් හරි වැරද්දක් හින්දානේ බී තුනක් එන්නේ නැත්තේ. මොකද්ද ඒ වැරද්ද කියලා. එහෙම කල්පනා කර ඉදි මන් තේරුම් ගත්ත දේ තමයි පුතේ මම ගණන් හදලා තියෙන්නේ හැමදේම කරලා තියෙන්නේ. ගුරුවරු කියන දේ ඒ විදිහටම අරන් කරනවා මිස මම හිතලා නැහැ. මම හිතුවා මම දැන් පාඩම් කරන්නේ මේවා අරගෙන හිතන්න පටන් ගන්නවා කියලා. මම පටන් ගත්ත ගිනුම් කරන සමීකරණෙන් හිතන්නේ. ඇයි C ධන L සමානයි A කියලා උගන්නා. ටිකක් වෙලා හිත හිත යද්දි මම හිතනවා C ධන L සමානයි A කියන එක වැරදි. වැරදිනේ. C ධන L සමානයි A වෙනවා. බිස්නස් එක පටන් ගත්ත වෙලාව. ඊට පස්සේ රිසර්ව් වෙන්න පටන් ගත්ත ගමන් සී නෙමෙයි නී නේ නේ මම මං හිතන්න ගත්තා. ඊට පස්සේ මාස දෙකක් විතර වැඩ කරා මේ තුනක් ආවා. මං කරේ හිතපු එක විතර. හද මේකේ හොඳම දේ පුතේ මේ ගමන යන හිතන්න. හිතනවා කියන්නේ ගුරුවරයා කියපු දේම ආපහු හිතන්න එපා. එතකොට මං වගේ කෙනෙක් වෙනවනේ. අලුතෙන් හිතන්න ඕන. හරි. කුමාරතුංග මුනිදාස මහත්තයා කවියකුත් ලියලා දෙන්න පුතේ අලුත් අලුත් දෑ නොතරන ජාතිය ලොව නොනගී කියලා. අහලා තියෙද නැහැ නේ? දැන් ඉස්කෝලේ ඒව උගන්වන්නේ නැහැ නේ? දැන් මං හිතන්නේ ඉස්කෝලේ වල පොත්වල ඇත්ත චින්ති ගේම සින්දු. නේද? ඉස්කෝලේ අරවා ඉස්සර අපේ කාලේ ඉගෙනනවා අලුත් අලුත් දෑ නොතරන ජාතිය ලොව නොනගී කියලා. You won't be able to success if you are not innovative. To become a chartered accountant, you have to have a innovative thinking. Not like your lecturer, mentor, or the guide thinking. You have to think more than that. While I'm explaining, listen to me. And think whether he is correctly telling it. If there is a doubtful thing, think again on that. And try to argue with the mind. You have to use arguable mind always. Right? If you have a chance, please go to University of Kelaniya gym. There is a nice sentence there. What is it? Kelaniya gym එකේ ගිහලා බලන් gym එකේ ගහලා තිනු අපි මිනිසුන් තනන්න ඕන අපි සමග යාමට නෝ අප පසු කර යෑමටයි කියන. දැන් ඔයාලා ගුරුවරයා කියන දේම අහගෙන මං කියන දේම අහගෙන ගියාම මං වගේ කෙක් වෙලා වැඩක් තියද? මං වගේ කෙනෙක් කොහොමවත් වෙන්න එපා. හරි. ඊට වඩා වැඩියෙන් හිතන්න එපා එන්නේ. One day you must be a lecturer and lecturing කියන්නේ. Clear? Don't only become a follower. එහෙම හිතෙන්නද lecturing කරන්න මෙතන? Joke නේ. ඒම පර්පස් එකකින් ගන්න. එතකොට ඔයාලගේ ගමන ලේසි වෙනවා. හරි. Okay, let take the question again. Now see, don't try to calculate anything. Examine ask what is the quantity if you want to earn 6000 profit. What is the 6000 profit according to my definition? Additional contribution after the profit. Sorry, after the zero profit. At the zero profit, contribution is equal to the fixed cost. Is that clear? Therefore, with additional profit, total contribution will be fixed cost plus expected profit. Clear? Therefore, this 6000 plus fixed cost. Fixed cost per unit, budgeted quantity, therefore fixed cost will be 10,000. Then 10,000 plus 6000, 16,000 is the total contribution for the 6000 profit. Contribution for unit 4. 16,000 divided by 4 is 4000. Is it clear? Therefore, answer is C. Second question, based on the same information, what they are asking? What is company's margin of safety for the budgeted period if fixed cost proved to be 20% higher than budgeted? Fixed cost will be 20% higher than budgeted. Question, what is the company's margin of safety for the budgeted period if fixed cost proved to be 20% higher than budgeted? 20% higher than budgeted means it will be 12,000 fixed cost. What is, why? Current fixed cost is 10,000. We already calculated. Is that clear? Therefore, if it is 20% higher than budgeted means you will have 12,000 fixed cost. If 12,000 fixed cost, your break even point will be how much? 3000 units. Clear? 3000 units. What is company's margin of safety for the budgeted period if fixed cost proved to be 20,000 higher than the budget? This is the quantity you are going to produce. Clear? If you consider the increased fixed cost, your break-even point will be 3000. Got it? Then margin of safety will be 2000. Is that clear? Okay. Then 2000 on 5000, it is 40%. Agree? Right? Clear? Current fixed cost 10,000, increased by 20%, that is 120%, it will be 12,000. At a 12,000, break-even point will be 3,000. You budgeted to produce 5,000. You have additional 2,000 units, that is margin of safety. As a percentage of 5,000, it is 40%. Okay? Question 4, same question, right? If the selling price and variable cost increase by 20% and 12% respectively, selling price and variable cost, they have not specified which variable cost. Commonly mentioned, variable cost increase by 12%, selling price increase by 20%, right? Respectively, by how much must sale volume change compared with the original budgeted level in order to achieve the original profit? Okay, first let's see. Clear? What is the current profit? Clear? Right. original budgeted profit should be there, even it change. Let's see what is the current budget profit. Contribution per unit, I think you will tell me. How much? Dollars 4. Right, dollars 4. How many units you producing? 5,000. What is the margin of safety? 2,000. No, 3,000. 2,500. Why? If it is not increased to 10,000 to 12,000, if it is increased 10,000 to 12,000, margin of safety 2,000. Clear? But if it is remain as it is, fixed cost 10,000, BEP 2,500. Is that clear? Clear? Now this question has to be calculated assuming fixed cost has increased or without assuming fixed cost has increased. Clear? But all these three questions connected together. We have to assume fixed cost increase to 12,000. Clear? Right. If fixed cost increased to 12,000 from 10,000 as we discussed in the previous question, your margin of safety was 2,000. You already calculated. Clear? 2,000. Then profit will be how much? $8,000. Is that clear? Here we have assumed fixed cost increase from 10,000 to 12,000. Agreed? Right. Profit ta kaadu pari therunadu pute? Contribution per unit into margin of safety. I margin of safety ekin vedi kaan contribution? Because we know contribution from first unit to break even point has to be put in a locker to pay the fixed cost. Once it fulfill, any additional contribution we will earn can be put into our pocket. Is that clear? Therefore, margin of safety is the quantity will make a profit for us. Is that clear? Right. Now this is the profit. You have to maintain this profit in the new situation. What is the new situation? Selling price increased by 20%. Current selling price 10. Arne? Current selling price 10 will increase by 1.2. Therefore, it will be $12. Clear? Current variable cost 6. Arne the question kali agatne? Variable cost 6 increased by 12%. 12% kiya lagya 7.2 veno adha bala multiplied by 1.12. Edo vada eni kiya 7.2 de. Sorry? 6.72. 6.72. Then alut contribution nakena contribution. How much? 5.28. You should have to maintain current profit. Current profit how much? 8,000. Clear? What is the current fixed cost? 12,000. Clear? Therefore, to have 8,000 profit with 12,000 fixed cost, total contribution will be 20,000. Clear? Divide it by 5.28. You can have the new number of units to be produced. How much? Bidinad? By how much? Sorry? No, no, I am asking what is the quantity. What is 20,000? Expected profit 8,000 plus. Fixed cost 12,000. Total contribution at 8,000 profit. What is 5.28? Contribution per unit. New contribution per unit. Now what is the answer? Quantity to be produced to have 8,000 profit. Tell me. How much? $3,087. That means the question is that correct? If the selling price and variable cost increase by 12%, 10-20% and 12% respectively, by how much sales volume change compared with the original budgeted level in order to achieve original budgeted profit? Now to have 10,000 profit, right? Sorry, 8,000 profit as we calculate originally, you have to sell only 3,787.87 quantity. But originally have the 8,000 profit, you sold 5,000 units. That's a reduction. What is the reduction? Difference? What's the difference in minus? It is that reduction is minus. How much? 1,212, rounded figure. 12.12, 12.12, should be 3 because there are 7. Clear? Finally, total will be 5,000. Right. Divide by 5,000. How much as a percentage? Twenty-four point two decrease. Answer A. Clear? The reduction from 5,000 to 3,787. The question was by how much quantity was has to be changed. Now we were earned 8,000 profit. Now I will take this my calculation. Look this, right? Originally we were earned 8,000 profit when we are producing 5,000 units. Remember, right? Then what happened? We have increased selling price into 12, variable cost into 6.72. Therefore, our contribution was increased from 4 to 5.28. Clear? Now, examiner asking question to maintain the same profit. That is, to maintain the same profit, how much the quantity need to be changed? Need to be changed means from the existing point of 5,000. First, we have to calculate what is the new quantity. To have the same profit with fixed cost, it would be 20,000 contribution. Is that clear? I told you, when there is an expected profit, contribution will be fixed cost plus expected profit. Clear? Fixed cost was increased to 12,000 in the question 2, previous question. Therefore, now it is 20,000. Total contribution to have the same profit. Contribution per unit, new information, 5.28. Therefore, to have this profit with new contribution, you have to sell 3,787.87 units. But to have the same profit, you have sold 5000 units previously. Now there is a reduction. That reduction is the difference between 5000 and this. It's a minus 1212.13. Reduction as a percentage of the original, not 50,000. I have incorrectly typed 50,000, that should be 5000. The reduction as a percentage of the original quantity is 24.2%. Is that clear? I think it is clear for you, right? Okay, let's try to do this. Write down this information. I will copy this into an Excel sheet, right? Let's try to do that. Now they have told you, don't consider the numbers, right? Just consider the name. These are the information given in the question. I am going to teach you something, right? You have been given expenses in different categories. This is cost per unit, right? This is cost per unit. Cost per unit. Per unit. When you producing 100,000 units. Is that clear? This is per unit cost when you producing, I will delete it, when you produce 100,000 units, this is the cost per unit. Is that clear? When you producing 150,000 units, this is cost per unit. Actually, this is cost per unit. That means you can calculate total cost under this category. If you take this set as a single box and this set as another box, now this is per unit basis. It has been given after divide by 100,000 units. Therefore, each and every value you can multiply it by 100,000, right? Then you have the total cost. Clear? This is the value. Now, when it's come to here, the cost is same. Can you see that? Per unit. Therefore, this is a variable cost. This also same. Therefore, it's also a variable cost. But when it's come to these three, it is not same. Not same means within this cost, you have fixed cost and variable cost, or sometimes only fixed cost. Why? The nature of the fixed cost, can you remember I told you at the beginning today? When the quantity increasing, fixed cost per unit will decrease. But even it is decreased, we cannot say always it is fixed cost. Clear? Let's see. Right? Everything has been increased by 100,000. Here we will take, this will by 150,000. To fix that 150,000 here. Now see here, cost per unit same. Therefore, it's a variable cost. Cost per unit same. It's a variable cost. No issue. Clear? But when it's come to here, cost per unit 10 for 100,000, cost per unit 7.5 for 150,000. If it is purely fixed cost, the total value would be same. Is that clear? But total value not same. This is 7.5 when quantity increase decrease to 5. If it is only a fixed cost, the total would be same. Yes, total is same. It's a fixed cost. It's a purely fixed cost. Is that clear? Therefore, I can say the direct material, what is it? Variable cost. Clear? Direct labor? Katagaran. Variable cost. Why? Cost per unit same in different quantities. When it's come to production overhead, what is it? Is it fixed cost? If it is fixed cost, total would be same. Per unit not same, but total would be same. Not same. This is semi-variable or semi-fixed cost. Semi-variable cost. Clear? Marketing expenses? Fixed cost. Total same. Administration? Semi-variable cost. Now what you need to do? For this and this, using high-low method, you require to calculate variable cost and fixed cost. Is that clear? Do it. Now, ara athana eka karanna ona puthe equation ekak. Da oka man othana kiwata oka therenne. Is that clear? Now calculate for production overhead and administration cost using high-low method. What is variable part and what is fixed part? If I take production cost first, high-low method is cost, different cost divided by different units, difference of the units. 125,000 is the difference of cost divided by 50,000 equal 2.5. Clear? Variable cost. Then fixed portion will be 1 million. Let's take this 1 million minus 2.5 into 100,000. Their fixed portion will be 750,000. You can check whether it is correct using the next quantity level, that is 1,125,000, clear, minus 2.5 into 150,000 units, cost should be same. Are the bala? Is it 750,000? If it is so, you correct. Otherwise, you incorrect. Correct. Okay. Now let's do it for other one is administration, right? Other one administration. The difference of the cost 100,000, right, divide by difference of quantity 50,000 equal to, right, they have a fixed portion is, let's take the first one, that is 500,000 case. 500,000 minus 2 into 100,000 equal 300,000. Fixed cost 300,000. Clear? Therefore, I can summarize like this. Variable cost, calculate, just calculate variable cost, 2 plus 5 plus here 2.5 plus here 2. Agreed? Clear? 2 plus 5 plus calculated production overhead variable 2.5 per unit. Calculated administration variable 2.5 here all together you have 25, no? Yeah. Then 29.5, correct? Kata karanna podi 29.5 variable cost per unit, hari patthaka liya ganna variable cost per unit 29.5. Is there an issue? No. Then let's calculate fixed cost. Okay. Here, the 750,000 is a fixed cost. Plus, then here also 750,000 plus here 300,000. That is 1.8 million. 750 plus 750 means 1.5 million plus 300,000, 1.8 million. 1,800,000. 1,800,000 is the fixed cost. Is that clear? Therefore, I can say like this. Total fixed cost 1.8 million. Okay. Variable cost per unit 29.5. Okay. Ready? Let's see the question now. Fixed costs are unaffected by the volume of output. Company management think they can sell 150,000 units per annum if the sales price is 49.5. If the sales price is 49.5, contribution will be 20. Why? Variable cost 29.5. 20. The break even point 1.8 million divided by, I will calculate here, this is sales price. Sales price was 49.5 minus our calculated variable cost 29.5. Therefore, contribution per unit will be $20. Therefore, break even point quantity will be the calculated fixed cost 1.8 million, right? Divide by 20 equal 90,000. 90,000 unit is the answer. Then put a maker of ready? Don't worry. In your case, they will ask many questions from this. What is the fixed cost of? Now, what are the cost can be considered as semi-variable cost out of this form? What are the only fixed cost here? What are the only variable cost here? Cost category? Classification question can be tested. Then high-low method can be tested. What is the marketing fixed cost? What is the total fixed cost? What is the variable cost per unit? What is the net profit? Likewise, any number of questions can be tested. Is that clear? Therefore, what you have to learn? The use of high-low method. What is the assumption? Not the assumption. Only variable cost per unit remain constant. With the quantity will increase. Clear? Only fixed cost, total remain constant, per unit will change according to the quantity. Semi-variable cost, per unit and total both different. Got it? New thing you learn. Variable cost, per unit same, total different. Fixed cost, total same, per unit different. Semi-variable, both different. Clear? That's the learning outcome. Now, easily you can decide at the MCQ question. Clear? Okay. Let's meet tomorrow for the balance.